arena. That has gone out. So we've not been able to have the folks hear us, but I think we can tell by the crowd reaction. I do believe it's the Scotsman coming through the crowd. Oh, this has got to be one of the biggest matches in years. Ties back to the days of Lonnie Mean. Some of the great ones between Ramos and Savage. The hair goes on the line. Luke Williams will be coming out. And the cry Rapros is going on. Miller is out there along with Playboy Buddy Rose. Now,
I don't know if you're behind all these posters, but before my match starts, I do not want to see any posters when I'm in the ring with Frank Vincent.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next match will be one fall to a finish, and the loser has agreed to have his head shaved. This is more or less a challenge match. Introducing in this corner, 240 pounds from New Zealand, the sheep herder, Luke Williams.
But Gelda.
His opponent in this corner, 242 pounds from Scotland, Rowdy Roddy Piper. Ladies and gentlemen, I refuse to let these guys sit here as a second for them, and I'm calling on the guards right now to handcuff these two guys to that post so they will not get a chance to be in there.
Thank you, God, the back room are waiting up. Get your rump roast down there, Rose.
Go ahead, guards. Handcuff them to the ring there, Al.
Okay. Al has the cuffs up.
Read the door or else.
Charge the security out here.
Now everyone stay away from the ring.
Yeah, it will be doubly important for people to stay away from the ring.
Yes, you either do it or you get put out of the arena.
Well, that original army.
Okay, let them go.
And Don Owens say, okay, let them go. And remember, the loser gets shaved. And they are going right at it. Williams, body slam. Rose up screaming, but they'll not be able to do anything. He's handcuffed to the ring. Roddy Piper going after it with Luke Williams. Brings Williams
Ten
out.
10 minutes remaining.
Flying knee lift. Covers him with a body press. Has the leg on the rope. Thumb in the eye. Oh. And now coming back. Watch out. Piper's in trouble and he's over in that corner. They may be handcuffed, but they got one hand loose. One, two, almost, not quite. See, Louis Panzella does all the barbering in these matches. Just spotted him at ringside. Piper gets loose. Coming right back at him, Luke Williams. Locks in karate. Comes back with a judo shot of his own. Being worked over in the corner. Piper by Luke Williams.
8 minutes remaining. 8 minutes.
Rose gets a hold of a foot of Piper. He is handcuffed to the corner, but if Williams can get him in there, get Piper in there, they can still get one arm free to work on him. And it's a reverse whip. Williams goes in the corner, lifted and body slammed as it comes out. Flying tackle puts Williams down. And out of control. One, two, and almost three. Piper out of control. Crashes head into Williams, and he went down. I don't
know.
7 minutes. Our director might be thinking of going along in this show tonight. The way this thing is going, we'll see what happens. Lift for the body slam. One, two, and not quite. Williams going to the top turnbuckle to come after Piper. He leaps and misses. Piper covers him. One, two, and he's able to flail kick out of it. Piper coming back, flailing away at the head of Luke Williams. Takes him into the ropes, and it's a reverse whip. Oh! Piper flying through the air. Piper flying through the air, hits Sandy Barr. Barr went out. There's a steel chair in there, and falling right on top of it. And a drop kick. Piper drop kicked the chair into the head of Luke Williams. Williams is out of it, but so is Sandy Barr. Barr is out of it on the far side. Piper, when his drop kick hit the chair went into the head of Luke Williams. He's counting Williams out. Sandy Barr counted Williams out. This place is going wild. Dusick. Dusick coming to congratulate Roddy. Here comes Stan the Man. They want to be there. There's Hennessy. There's Parsons. They want to be there to see the hair fly. Williams is trying to run. Williams trying to run. Hennessy, Parsons, Stasiak have a hold of him. Roddy Piper. They're banging him in the head. Well, a barber's chair is set up. I don't know if Louis ought to get up there. Louis Panzella's the barber. They may have to do it themselves. Somebody's asked for the handcuffs. Stasiak has given him the handcuffs. They've got one cuff on Williams. Piper, Bellingham, Rose, and Miller wisely, I would say, standing back. There goes the hair. Sandy Barr's doing the job. The hair goes flying, and look at Stasiak. Stasiak is loving it. The hair's coming off. Piper gleefully watching. Williams, the whole army challenged Piper to a hair match last week. He has been turning down a hair match. Trying to get it. Oh, what an ugly shot that is. A good shot, but an ugly picture. Hair is coming off, and Rose beside himself that he can't do anything about it. There's too many of them there. Sandy Barr doing the shaving. Now Miller trying to get in to interfere. Bilsack unloads on Rose. Oh, that's what you really call rubbing it in. Going bald. Luke Williams. Now Miller coming on the microphone.
Papa, I want you in a hair match. I want your hair.
Rose and Miller both saying we want to get even. Luke Williams getting as bald as a billiard ball. There he is. He looks naked. Well, we'll be right back. A lot of things yet to go. Let's hold on here a minute. They're still flailing away at each other. Piper is thrown out of there. Well, now they're bailing out. We'll be back in a minute after this timeout.
Your brother to me. We've been partners for 12 years. We've never been ridiculed like this in our life. Piper, you're gonna pay, brother. You're gonna make for that boot injury in me. Piper, you're not getting away with it. That's my partner. That's my brother.
Listen, Tuesday night.
That's my partner, everybody.
Oh, listen to this.
He's got his hair off.
Tuesday night. The Giant and Piper against you, your partner, and the General, Buddy Rose. You can have Piper. Luke can have
Piper. I'm going to get you, Piper. I'm going to make you pay for that hair, you hear me? You're not going to ridicule him like that.
It's Chehalis. There's Yakima. There's Chehalis tomorrow. There's Yakima Monday. Portland Tuesday. Bedford Wednesday. Hermiston on Thursday. Eugene on Friday. You put the army in against them anywhere but Tuesday night. For sure, the army, the undefeated army, is going to take on the Giant and Piper. We've never lost, Piper.
I want Piper, buddy. Let me have him. You've got to let me have him.
Here's what we'll do. Luke and I'll get the Giant arm in arm. We'll throw him into Piper, you old Piper, and then you do what you want with him.
I'm going to crunch him, buddy. I'm not only going to take his hair off, I'm going to send him out of this territory like we did Rick Martel on a stretcher.
Now they say Rick Martel's going to be back next Saturday, and he wants one of us. Martel, if you come back like they say next Saturday, Saturday will be your last night. You're coming in, and we're going to run you right back out. But Tuesday, we've got a lot on our mind. Every night this week, we've got a lot on our mind. But
The Tuesday night is the one, brother.
I want him. Piper, you're gonna pay, brother. You're gonna pay. That's my family, you shake. That's my partner. We grew up on a farm next door to each other.
We know each other well.
I tell you something, he belongs to me and I belong to me, and you're gonna pay for that, Piper. You're gonna pay for it. Listen here, Frank. I'm gonna say it right here in front of millions of people.
What?
Piper, I want you in an air match. I want him.
I do.
I want him, Buddy Rose.
You want him?
He's mine, yes.
Can you beat him?
I want him. Yes. I'm going to beat him.
Listen, Piper won't sign the WrestleMania hair match. I asked him.
Butch Miller is asking for one. Please, Piper, one more time with any of us. Please. You were lucky, Piper. The referee was out and you were lucky, but you're not going to be so lucky with me. You hear that? Piper, as well as taking your hair off, I'm going to get you on Tuesday and open you up, you hear me? Split you from end to end.
And we'll take care of the Giant.
We're putting a stop to it now. They need a double stretcher. One for Martel and one for you, Piper.
Well, two of the most popular wrestlers of late in the Pacific Northwest, Rick Martel, many think he's going to become just as well-liked and as popular as the great Jimmy Snuka, now making international name for himself.
The next TV interview
back in North Carolina.
Falls or to a TV time limit in this a tag team match. Introducing the team of Butch Miller and Luke Williams. Their opponents in this corner, Roddy Piper and Rick Martel.
Roddy Piper. Rick Martel, and it was Martel last Thursday down at Salem who insisted that a week from next Thursday at Salem be kids' night. He's the one that went to the promoter and said, I want the kids in free with each paid adult admission. Don Owen is the one that decided to do it for next Saturday here at the Portland Sports Arena, where there will be no television, incidentally. With a card Tuesday, of course, no television. Well, there, I was going to say never. I was going to see that there has been no television. Now some talk over in the corner. Buddy Rose wants to stay down at ringside. The crowd is yelling for him to go away. I don't know what Barr has decided or can do. The Sheepherders, incidentally, are the heavyweight tag team champions of the Pacific Northwest. Buddy Rose. Now, here's Barr. Let's listen.
Rose, I'm serious about this. This match will not take place if you stand there. It won't start until you're in the dressing room.
Butch Miller, really angered of the opinion by Sandy Barr, and he is watching carefully now to see that he gets all the way into the dressing room. Butch Miller, Luke Williams, it's Ricky Martel, and neither one of them too anxious to start. Of course, Martel put out of action here 3 or 4 weeks ago by these two guys with the help of Rose. And he wants Ricky Martel, young freshman. Now, both of them want to go at it. Piper climbs between the ropes. Says, okay, we'll both go at it. Now Piper going to start instead of Martel. Side headlock, Luke Williams on Piper. Roddy. Piper trying to turn over the Wrist lock and tag Martel. When Luke Williams saw Martel coming in, he hit it for outside the ring. Miller keeps yelling. Ricky and Roddy are number one. Well, they certainly are to a lot of people. They aren't to Butch Miller, though. Miller has been haranguing since he got there in the ring for their instructions in this match, haranguing at Roddy Piper about a hair match. The tag to Martel, and again, Luke Williams goes sailing out. Luke Williams lost his crop of hair in a hair match against Roddy Piper. And even at that, he's willing to get in that ring against Piper, but hesitates to do so against Rick Martel. And I tell you, when Martel gets on a rampage, and he has been since he got back, he is something else again. Luke Williams in against Piper as the arm bar turns it over. Forearm smash on that. It now goes to the hammerlock. He's just been joined up in the crow's nest by Cowboy Lang. And if we got our signals right, I understand he's going to be at Hillsboro. The Midgets will be at Hillsboro tomorrow night. And they're pulling at the hair. Well, Miller says, I'll get his hair one way or another. If he won't go in a hair match with me, I'll pull it out of there. Tag. Luke Williams in. He catches a roundhouse right from Piper. Now gives him one back and another. Flying mare for the takedown. Go behind. Luke Williams for the headlock from behind. Roddy Piper. And of course, the real excitement everybody's waiting for is when Martel gets in there and can keep one of the sheep herders between the ring ropes. But nah, he missed it. Thought he had the tag. A headlock worked by Luke Williams. One of the Kiwis going in to interfere. Miller, he is taken out. The tag for Rick Martel. And Sandy Barr is disallowing the tag. Sandy Barr disallowing the tag. Miller whipped out of the corner before Martel can get back there. Into the knee of Miller. The tag, Miller coming in with Piper over in their half of the corner. Their half of the ring, I should say. From pillar to post, one turnbuckle to another. Miller tearing at the hair. Now off the top rope, Luke Williams after the tag. In the back of the head, Miller trying literally to pull a hair. And now Williams too, out of Piper's head. Williams having lost his head to Piper in a hair match. Piper is trying to power his way over. Now he's carrying, makes the tag, and watch out. Katie barred the door. Williams did not get out of the ring. He tried to. Miller comes up from behind. Williams whipped into him. The Frenchman is wailing. And a whip. But he goes up to the second rope, can flying off with a flying body press. Rick Martel wins the first fall for his team.
And 51 seconds, clear of the first ball. Piper. Piper and Martel.
Picard's in Seattle, 624-4970. And we're ready to get action underway. Luke Williams in against Rick Martel. Martel, top wrist lock, grinding down on it. Leg drop across the left arm. It's in the corner. And Martel working on the left arm. Luke Williams, he tags, coming in to take over the job. Now the pump handle by Piper, one time. Had that arm bar turned underneath it and brought it down across the shoulder. The pump handle now goes to Jerkin on that left arm. Williams has taken most of the punishment. Body slam coming up and going down. Piper covers him with a body press. One, two, and she murders neither one. Go away that easily. Kick to the arm by Piper. Piper goes to whip. He is whipped on the reverse, but he comes up with a knee on Williams coming in after him. Miller is in to interfere. And Martel takes over for Piper, although there was no tag. They faked it. And there was a question about whether they tagged last time, one previous time or not. Sandy Barr's going to let this one go. Oddly enough, the last time they did tag, and he ruled that they didn't. Miller coming in to interfere. They slap hands again. That is, Piper slaps his hands together as he comes in, making the sound of a tag. And Miller saying a man's in illegally. Sandy Barr asked the crowd over that way, and they say yes. There was a tag. Williams and Miller has not been in there much. He was pinned by Martel by a flying press. Martel coming off the second turnbuckle when he was whipped into the corner. That's how he won the first fall. With a hammerlock, Piper. Miller is not there to take the tag. He gets back a little too late. We got Big Mac out here in the floor, one of our crew. I guess he's got his work all done. He's just running around and trying to break up the announcer. Alan McDonald is his name. If anybody wants to take the name and call into the station. Rick Martel in with the wing lock on the mostly bald painted skull of Luke Williams. Rick Martel from France and a super athlete in any sport. I don't think you will find in any sport any greater athlete than this young man. Going for the tag and missing it, Miller. Williams really getting worked on. Sandy Barr checking the action. Martel with the hold on Williams. Miller trying to sneak in from down the road a little ways there. Crowd alerts referee Sandy Barr, and he's sent back. Got a reverse arm bar on him. Looking in through the corner, or against the ropes, rather. Luke Williams missed the elbow. Threw the elbow at him, catches a drop kick, and is slammed to the floor. Arm drag slam. The Piper is in. And Sandy Barr not allowing that one. Piper, in going out, pulls Williams all the way over there. In their corner. There's the tag. Rowdy Roddy coming in. And a kick. They are working on that left arm. And remember who came to town and started that stuff a few years ago. About three now, I believe. One playboy, Buddy Rose. Jay Youngblood, a number of other people. Put out of the wrestling business for a while, usually on that left arm. And Williams is getting that treatment, the treatment that Rose and friends used to put out. Now Williams is getting it from Piper and Martel. Whip into the ropes. Judo chop. Piper wound up, could be it. One, two, no. Not enough. There's the tag coming off the top ropes as Martel. Elbow smash, elbow drop actually, off of the top turnbuckle to the left arm. And Luke Williams is really getting worked on. Martel and Piper. And Williams telling Miller to get ready. They've got Martel in trouble. Whipped him into a cross and double judo chop right to the throat. Now Miller in. Remember, Williams has been in quite a while, so Miller is fresh. Oh! He planted Martel with an elbow right to the point of the chin. Piper in, I believe, to save him this time. I think he only got a count of two. Sandy Barr warning him to stay out. Pile driver coming up. And he did not get him way up in the air, but he got banged his head into the mat, canvas pretty well. All the way across the ring, and it's a turnbuckle treatment for Martel. Martel groggy. Miller working on him. To the midsection, into the head. Now setting it for a whip into the knee. Of Williams from outside. Williams got in his second breath. He comes back in. And immediately gets caught with a roundhouse right from Martel. But Martel had a little taken out of him. And he didn't have much in that roundhouse right. A headbutt to the side of the head by Williams. Williams, the whip. Martel hard into the corner. A kick to the midsection. A roundhouse right is blocked by Martel. He comes back with his own. But couldn't put Williams away with it. Williams now bringing him over, crashing his head. Side of the head into the knee of Miller. Now it's Miller in. Martel trying to get over and tag out as he is in trouble. Miller in to work on him. And he leapfrogs Miller. Miller was going for a shoulder throw. Miller wants to get out of there. He gets over and tags Williams. Martel trying to tag Piper and misses by about 3 inches.
6 minutes remaining.
And ready with the whip. Leapfrog drop kick. Martel puts him down. Dive for the tag and got it. Here comes Roddy.
5 minutes.
Roddy unloads. And Miller grabs Piper, takes him into the corner. Now here comes Martel. Martel being sent out of the ring. They are double teaming on Piper. Got him draped feet across the bottom rope. Williams is holding him out. And this match is all even. We are all even. One fall apiece. We'll be right back after we hear from Tom Peterson. And Martel catch Williams. Now Miller's coming out. They're going at it outside the ring. Martel unloading on Williams. Miller gets Piper inside the ring. Now Miller. Miller and Piper going at it. We got Martel and Williams in their places. Miller out, Williams in. Elbow drop. It's a count of two on Piper, but that is all. Being taken over to the Kiwi's corner. Luke Williams tags Miller and then holds Miller in with a kick on Piper. Ball apiece, remember. If Martel and Piper can win this one, what they want more than anything is Rose, of course, but they'll also should be given a shot at the championship belt. There's the tag. Here comes Martel. Goes downstairs. Now everybody's in the ring. Suplex drop on Williams. The Cobra put on Miller. The Cobra put on Miller and Buddy Rose. Buddy Rose out of the dressing room. And they've got a scissors. They brought a scissors in. And Miller is going to get his hair cut off. They brought it in to get some of Piper's hair. Scissors finally goes down, and here's some help out of the dressing room. Sal Martino, Crusher Stasiak, Parsons, and it's going to be about everybody. Stasiak across the way holding Miller in place. Sal Martino on the far right of your camera holding Piper in his corner, and now Martino goes flying and Piper gets at Miller. Down at ringside, Don Owens looking on. And winning it on a disqualification, Piper and Martel. Piper and Martel, and we're going to keep it here. We'll keep it right here. No more commercial timeouts. We're going to keep it here. Don Owens is down at ringside.
I want to know who put those scissors in the ring.
Don Owens, last time, Roddy Piper got a hair snip of his hair taken off. You made sure that he had to go in a hair match with Luke, and Luke had to accept it.
You
but
I'm
pleading with you.
Get over here.
I'm pleading with you, Donald. He's gonna slip out of my ear. Now it's my turn with him. You've got to tell him to make the match. You've got to do it, Owens. You did it last time. You've got to do it this time, by God.
What he's saying is, you made Luke take a match with Piper. Now you make Piper take a match with Butch Miller in a hair match. Tuesday night.
In all fairness, we did make him do it. We made him accept the match. So, in all fairness, being a promoter, I'm supposed to be fair. So, since he wants a hair match, I think he should give it to him. Tuesday night.
One more thing. Luke Williams did not have a good referee. I should referee the match.
I want you to referee, buddy. I want you as a referee.
Tuesday night.
Hold it just a second. You're trying to tell me that you're going to force me into a hair match because I cut some of his hair when they tried to do it to me in the first place? Yeah. Well, let me tell you something. You want a hair match? You guys think you got it all figured out, don't you? Well, listen, you want a hair match with me Tuesday, brother? You want Buddy Rose as the referee? Well, then listen, you give me a hair match Tuesday with him and Rose as the referee. But one thing, I want Rose there where I can see him, but if he's gonna get a referee, so am I, and I choose Ricky Martel.
I agree with them. If you're gonna have him for referee, he should sure heck have one.
Yes, sir.
All right, next Tuesday, you can referee Rose.
Yeah, what about Luke here? What about Luke? Listen, Don Owens, if you're a fair promoter like you're supposed to be, why don't you handcuff him in the dressing room where he can't get out?
Don Owens says okay.
Handcuff me to the ringside. No, you won the hair match so darn bad. He won the hair match so bad, you're going to have one now.
Tuesday night, I'm going to be able to sleep again. I'm going to be able to dream pleasant dreams because, Piper, your head's going to be bone as a badger.
Woo.
Okay, it is me. Two referees, Martel and Rose Williams, will be handcuffed in the dressing room. We're out of time.
All right, now, Piper.
Thanks a lot for being with us.
Piper.
We're out of time.
Your last night, Tuesday night.
From the Portland Sports. And that side headlock again. Far deep. Having a good look at it. After the first fall of this main event, well, again, rundown matches for you. And you'll be seeing them on your screen. And I'll be reading those very quickly. Just speed through those and give you some of the things coming up in the near future. A little bit farther ahead into the following week. Side headlock. Buddy Rose. In the hole of Steve Pardee. Talking earlier about telegrams received so far by Piper and Rose. One more on Piper, Andy Kaufman, star of the television series Taxi. Oh, suplex drop. Rose got him up in the air, off his feet, and brought him back hard, but Rose also hit the deck hard. Don't know if he can follow him up here with a pin or not. Usually with that suplex drop the way he had it, you'd be able to pin the man right away if you got to him right away. And Rose did not. He apparently knows he didn't have him hurt enough. He wants to work on him some more, choking on that top rope and jerking him off it. Left hand. That was an open hand. Legal blow. Kick with the top of the boot, also legal, incidentally. And Buddy Rose yelling Roddy Piper before he threw that one. Whip, shoulder throw. And he got him up and twisted besides throwing him, which really can injure a man. Inside out, backbreaker. The Billy Robinson backbreaker, the first fall, I do believe, yes, to Buddy Rose. Once he puts that one on, it is very tough to get out of. Well, there is the playboy. Now, once again, we'll remind you. We are going to show you, I think, when camera one backs up. That's really been a ball for me. It continues to be Rose. Body slams on Pardee. Being down at Salem just about every Thursday, I'll tell you, Martell and Piper got their work cut out for him this Thursday. I hope to see a lot of you folks. Howdy and shake and talk some wrestling and autographs if you care for them. Rose won the first fall inside out. Billy Robinson backbreaker. Incidentally, the show Big Time Wrestling syndicated around the Pacific Northwest. Now showing you folks, some of you folks getting this program up in the Puget Sound area or near it might want to know the Big Time Wrestling's on teleprompter of Seattle, Viacom Television, and C10 Puget Sound if you want to watch us up there. Front headlock now, swinging away with the left hand. Rose on Pardee. He won the first fall against Pardee. Working on him hard. Playboy Buddy Rose coming into one of the, I'll tell you, it is just going to be one of the spots in wrestling history. High spots. And blood now flowing. Rose has opened a cut on Pardee. Pardee, face turning literally into the oft-described crimson mask. That's just about exactly what it's becoming. Buddy Rose bringing blood and working on it on Pardee. He is just trying to, at this point, he is working at nothing more than hurting Pardee. Incidentally, we have no more breaks, no more timeouts, so stay with us. Well, a good shot. It's brutal, but that's part of wrestling, just like injuries are part of any sport. Buddy Rose continues popping away. And the match, I do believe. We'll have to see if it's a fall disqualification or a match disqualification. Sandy Bar is hot. Well, we will just hold it here then. According to Woody, Mr. Dunwoody down at the ringside. My friend Woody. And I would be very surprised if this match can continue. If it's a fall disqualification, then it is going to be a draw, each man winning a fall. Let's just hold on and find out what the case is going to be here. We'll leave our cameras down there and see Pardee. No more timeouts, so we're going to hold it right here. things as can be. Now we are out of break, so we're going to stay right here with it. We don't know if they had an interview ready to come up or not, so we'll just stay here and talk about it a little bit. Talked about promoters that are coming in for the hair match. And we understand one's promoter from Charlotte and Dallas are coming. Now, Buddy Rose is back in the ring. Sandy Barr is in his dressing room. Sandy Barr is in the official's dressing room, and they don't always have monitors. Here comes Barr. Barr rolling out, calling for the bell. Looking at it, and a crowd really riled. Sandy Barr came out. Well, the rest period was not up when Rose bolted from the dressing room, got in on Pardee, and it just... Now Sandy Barr is going to stop it. Sandy Barr is going to stop it due to that cut. That blood is flowing, and Barr is saying that it cannot continue. Buddy Rose is grinning, smiling. Up in a crow's nest where the Roddy
States, let me tell you something, Buddy Rose. You ain't gonna bet a young kid you're beating up in there, and you ain't gonna be able to take advantage of me Tuesday like that, brother, because you want to put your sticking foot up. I'll tell you what, Buddy Rose, the safety note is over, brother. I don't need no more safety note. I don't need no more nothing. I spend my times in the gym, Buddy Rose, and I'm more ready for you than I have ever been in my life. You want to put up your car? You put your stinking car up, Buddy Rose, and I'll leave town if I lose. But one thing, Buddy Rose. I'm going to bring in a special referee. The first man's hair that you ever cut is Red Bastien, and he's going to be the referee. Look at that. You stink, Rose. You listen to me, Buddy Rose. I ain't going to be no young kid Tuesday, Buddy Rose. Portland has done a lot for me, and it's my turn to do something for Portland, Buddy Rose. Come Tuesday the 15th, Buddy Rose, your face will be red from the lack of hair on your head, Buddy Rose. Portland, this one is for you, brother.
That's the word, short and sweet, from Rowdy Roddy Piper. We are out of time. Rose coming up. I'll just let him talk, but we are out of time.
He's gonna go bye-bye.
We'll see you later.
Bye-bye to Piper and his hair.
Good night, everybody. Getting ready. This is a non-title bout. Instructions being given. That's the best two out of three. Martell. Yeah, I told you we had a barn burner coming. And he's not too anxious. He pulls the mask up and down. You understand it. The mask in itself is not anything that he is that concerned with. It's the fact that it was the only way he could get in the ring with a wig. that he could manage to keep on his head. So it is sewn into that wig. Martel, and go behind by Rose. And as so often happens, oh, a flip over the top. A roll up, one, two, no, almost. It so often happens, this is not one of our biggest crowds of the year, even the season. It is a good one, but it is one of the noisiest. I think so often that's because they really died in the wall. Wrestling fans comes out, the signs come out, the yelling goes on. Wild things happen. Martel, side headlock, grinding down on it. First fall action, if you've been a little late in joining us, main event just underway. No falls yet. Couple of moves, and a third one by Rose, and you got to give him credit. He made the good move. Got a leg hold. Working on Martel with it. You hear the cry of the crowd. Martel, not caught in a figure four leg lock. Buddy Rose, bringing it up on top. Forearm smash, small of the back, as Martel tries to rise up against it. Sensational young man from France, making a real name for himself. Could have gone on already. He's had some offers, but he is making money, having success, and things to do here in the Northwest. One of them is to get that mask, and that's the wig, off of Rose. And for the first time since he originally had his hair cut, show the bald Buddy Rose. Throwing back on it. Usually bring you the schedule of upcoming cards after this first fall. Don't know if we'll have the opportunity to do that or not, but try to get it to you later in the show. Rose laying back, trying to get a little extra leverage. Almost got hit with a three count. He got caught with two. Got it in a figure four scissors leg lock. Buddy Rose with the hold on Rick Martel. And good shot of it. You see Rose not only having the hold, but he gets the rest. That is rest compared to what Rick is relative resting compared to what Rick is suffering. Tied up in a figure four scissors leg lock. Appears to be. It looks like Martel is tied up Rose's right leg. Now Rose trying to turn it back over and does. He's up with it. Trying to get it reapplied and does. Rose, again, line back, trying to rest, get a little added leverage, both. First ball action, just underway. Rose, looking into the camera right at you folks at home and saying, I got the smarts. It's the brains that does it for me. Continue to hold that figure four leg lock. Martel now looses himself from it. That's been, circulation's been cut off in that leg. Rose is up and at him. The cripplers are back at work. Savage, busted ankle. Donnelly O'Jonathan, ribs caved in. Piper, bruised back. He'll return next Saturday here to Portland Sports Arena. Left leg now. Inside toe hold. Rolled over. Cradle. One, two, and Rose almost bought it. Martel, really limping around, unable to put any weight in that leg. Rose, flying seat drop with the inside of the knee.
10 minutes gone.
And up on a hamstring. Martel got a headlock trying to pull him off the hold. Martel still caught in the toe hold. Yeah. keeping the toehold. Top of the leg lock again going and getting out of the way, Martel. Gets the leg out of the way. Sit out backbreaker. Martel, and he went to it on his left leg that has taken all that punishment. So I think he got hurt worse than Rose did. He gave a sit out backbreaker to Rose. But it was right on top of that knee that's been hurting. Watch out, Rose outside the ring over near that ring post. He's going to wrap the leg around it. And again, the left leg of Martel. Last week, a punishment given to Piper. And early in a match, team match, and he couldn't come out. Now they are working on that leg again. I think automatically think of the Army. Martel caught, and he's going to have to give it up. His left leg, Rose finally drops it. Rose, winner of the first fall. Playboy Buddy Rose.
In 12 minutes.
We'll be right back.
29 seconds.
We're going to take a timeout as we listen to Tom Peters. Answer the bell.
Chris Martel says the match will continue, and he's on his way out right now.
Well, there's that answer. Martel is being helped by security people down to ringside. He is limping badly on that left leg. And Rose holding the ropes apart for him. Martel is not going to, about to trust him. Martel is going to try to continue. I've also just been notified that if this match goes short, we have a standby bout for you. So let's see what happens. But Martel has had a full rest period now. He's coming back. Hardly able to move. Mobility pretty well gone. And that's what Rose is going after, that left leg. Well, the Cripplers have returned with a vengeance. It's been a while since they put anybody out. Business. It had been a while. But they're busy at it now. And by they, I keep referring to the Army. It's gotten to be when you see the Sheepherders, you think of Rose. And you see Rose, you think of the Sheepherders. In a corner, Rose. Ah, yeah. Now Rose wants to sucker him into the middle of the ring if he can. If he's on the corner, he can kind of lean on the ropes. And Martel is, well, circling as best he can. And he's caught in it. Caught in a scissors. The left leg in a scissors hold. Working on the left leg. Sandy Barr checking to see if it's legal. It is. He's grinding. Apparently, or if he's doing something illegal, he's not being caught. Martel, left leg, caught by Buddy Rose. Turning him over into a half crab, but Martel is under the ropes. And he turned him over. Now he pulls him back. And is going to pull back. Oh, he drives the knee. And it is the knee. Ligaments, cartilage. Might even be a cracked patella, the kneecap. Now working on the hamstring. He's trying to ruin that leg from the knee up to the hip. Playboy Buddy Rose, pulled back. Now going outside the ring with it. That left leg already. I would almost be sure there's a very good chance of ligaments being torn. And Rose grabbed by Martel in his head, slammed into the ring post. Now Martel back in. If Rose looks to be out to me, a count of 20, he could win a second fall. But can he come back for the third, even if he does? Now Martel's going out after him. Martel apparently did not care about winning it or losing it. He wants to punish him. He runs him small at the back flat into the ring post. Or maybe, and there's a good chance of this, he's a lot smarter than me and decided to punish him a little bit more, making it that more difficult for him to get back in the ring. I believe he is just out to get him now while he can. He is outside, stomping on Rose. Rose, the small of the back, run into that steel ring post. Martel working on Rose outside the ring. And again, into the ring post. Martel, gimpy on that left leg. I got a count of 6, 7, 8, and you know the count stops every time Martel goes on after him. Now the count is on both of them. Martel out after Rose, and now it's a reverse situation. It is Martel trying to do the hurting, and he wants him back in the ring. Martel moving better on that left leg. Well, dealing out the punishments can sometimes make yours feel a lot better. Martel with knee drops, small to the back. He twisted that leg again. That left leg still is not 100% by any means. Buddy Rose, the playboy. The crowd counting out the double club blows. He can't. Buddy Rose in nearly in a position of not being able to defend himself. Sandy Barr checked him and let it go. And the Boston Crab, if Martel can turn him over to it. He's got him putting on the pressure. And he's got it awfully well applied. And Rose has to give it up. It's all even. We're all even. All apiece. Martel does not want to drop the hold. Finally, on the count, does.
And 5 minutes and 53.
Listen to this
seconds.
Chair.
The winner of the second call, Rick Martel, on the submission.
Well, the winner of that fall heading for the dressing room. And we think all our sponsors are the ring, just now getting into it. Buddy Rose. They are center stage at the Portland Sports Arena. Well, Whip hard into the corner. Stay with us now. We are going to keep it right here. Brakes are out of the way. Backbreaker, yes, and he did it with his right leg this time. One, two, and a flail kick. Foot stomp, small to the back. It's that back. Martel wants to work on a shot to the midsection by Rose. Now he's lifted. Suplex drop on that back. Martel with a vengeance, to say the least. Turns him over. Knee drop coming up. Yes. But be a little careful, Rick. You drove it with that left one and gets it again. Left one apparently feeling better at the heat of action. Got him in a chin lock from behind, pulling back on it. Forearm smash. Fingers got in the eyes, Rose. Brings Martel out. Going for
eight
body slam. And he couldn't do it. Rose could not take the pressure of the weight. Holding Martel up above him, the back gave out. He had to just let him down on his feet. Rose unable to drive him. Uh-oh, this could do it. A grapevine. The abdominal stretch puts a lot of pressure on that back. Rose grabs the hair of Martel, pulls him over. Martel has him in trouble. Whip into the corner, shoulder throw out of the corner. Going after the mask. Martel now going after the mask. That would be the supreme insult. Rose, who has said that people will not see me bald. I will wear wigs until my hair goes back to its original loveliness. Martel has it about halfway off to get that mask off. Up over toward the floor. Of course, it'll slip off from there. Rose now holding on to it. Martel gets it off. Martel gets it off, but the Sheepherders are there. Rose heading for the dressing room. Well, I hope you didn't turn your head. Rose has run to the dressing room. The Sheepherders. The Sheepherders got there. The count's going on. I do not think Rose is going to come back in a ring. He is all the way back to the dressing room. Sheepherders came out, saying he was in trouble. Rick Martel wins it as the mask and the wig.
And 4 minutes and 17 seconds.
Martel wins the match. Sandy Barr.
Rose did not return to the ring. Rick Martel.
I don't know what Sandy's explaining. We might have to get him up here. I think he is saying that he'll have to return the mask and the hair. That's it. He was explaining it. It's a part of the man's equipment, illegal equipment. Warren in the ring. Martel wants to keep it. Martel wins the match. He wanted to keep the mask and the wig, but Sandy Barr would not allow him to. I believe that is the ruling on it. We'll have to wait and see for sure, but quite sure that that's what it is. He's taking it back to the dressing room. Okay, we're going to keep it here. We're going to fill out the time, and I don't know if they're going to throw in a standby.
Introducing the challengers in this corner, the New Zealand sheep herders, Butch Miller and Luke Williams. Their opponents and the defending champions are Roddy Piper and Rick Martell.
Well, you heard the crowd. No guessing who they are for. A lot of well-made signs around tonight. We're kind of sorry in the limited space that we have here that we can't get the shots of the signs always that we'd like to bring to you. But you are always welcome. Bring us a sign up. Encourage whoever you're supporting. Cry is to get Buddy Rose out. It's a crowd of go, 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 a chant of go, go, go by the crowd. Rose, I think, is claiming that he will, should be able to stay down at ringside. Well, we'll see what happens. Action about ready to get underway. And at the end of the first fall, this best two out of three falls to a TV time limit. We'll be bringing you another quick review on where wrestling's coming up in the next week or so. There's the Playboy. And discussing, I'm sure, what his location will be during this match with Sandy Barr. Now, will he be down at ringside? Now, Piper is raising quite a ruckus about Rose not being able to be at ringside. Said he should be back in the dressing room. Well, Rose is down at ringside. The match is underway. Rose is being allowed to stay there, so we'll see what happens. Martell opening up against Luke Williams. And Luke's going to bail out. Rick Martell, the young Frenchman that has exploded on a professional wrestling scene. Rose down in the left-hand corner of your picture. You can see him just sat down in a chair. Luke Williams trying to turn over the top wrist lock. Miller gets the referee's attention. Williams is able to go to the hair. Piper came in without a tag. Sandy Barr just allowed it, but they kept the hold anyway. Luke Williams pulled out of the reach of Miller's tag. Former champions, the Kiwis, going after that title, but they lost to this team of Martell and Piper. So that's coming down hard on the arm. The whip, that shoulder. A lot of talk has been going on about the Cripplers. Their latest, they got Savage. They put Piper out for nearly 2 weeks. That's the Army, and I think Piper and Martell would like to do a little crippling of their own. Working on the left arm of Luke Williams. Jerking on the armbar. Turn it over. Once more. And here comes Martell. Leapfrog and a seat drop. Right on that left arm. Rose. Up yelling about the injustice of it all. first fall action, and we're going to see a lot of it in this one. They're going to be up and down and around a lot. Going at each other. Roddy Piper, Rick Martel against the Kiwis, and it is more than just the championship match. There's a lot of spite, hatred in that ring. Williams, leapfrogged by Martel, catches him with his feet. Arm drag slam, and he's got him down that mat with a wing lock. And like a hockey team, they change on the fly. There wasn't any tag there, but referee's attention was diverted, of all people, by Miller. Williams hasn't been out of there. Piper with the hold on Williams. Wing lock. Into the ropes. Roddy throw it off, but comes back with a flying tackle. He is body slammed. Missing with the elbow drop is Williams. Miller taken out. Miller has to be very physically restrained by Sandy Barr, and while Sandy was busy doing that, Piper and Martel changed on the fly again without benefit of a tag, but not seen by referee Sandy Barr. Taking a page from the book of the Army. Piper in, Martel out. Williams still in there. He has not been able to get out. They're working on that left arm. And again, pulled out of range. Williams tried a kickoff, but missed it. Winglock down on the mat. Piper working on Williams. Rose is wandering all around that part of the ring where he's stationed. Working the wing lock, Rowdy Roddy Piper. And he's got Luke Williams in there. Williams has gone all the way for the Sheepherders. A vault over the top rope by Martel and down on that left arm of Luke Williams. Martel, the tag, Piper will come in. Flying elbow drop to that left arm. Now up to the hammerlock. Over the top, balding again, Martel. Comes down with his foot. All the pressure of height. Now he stopped as Piper comes in. And over the top rope again comes Martel. Foot stomp. Knee drop, all this happening to the left arm of Luke Williams. Rose going nuts down at ringside. Miller trying to come in. Sandy Barr forcing him back. We are in just first fall action. End of this fall wheel review. Where the action is coming up. There's the tag. Miller finally going to get in. And Sandy Barr didn't see the tag. Sandy Barr refuses to recognize the tag is legal. Miller going nuts over in this corner. And meanwhile, Piper and Martel keep up the punishment on Williams. A high knee drop. They got him to give it up. Williams could not take it any longer. Williams submit at punishment to his left arm.
In 8 minutes and 9 seconds, winners of the first call, the champions, Martel and Piper.
Well, the action got started while we were away there. As they got into the ring, or heading up into the ring, Piper, Belden Miller, who landed on Rose at ringside, then grabbed Williams and went right to work on him. And as you see there, back to work on that left arm. He has some kind of a bandage around it, a left elbow. They wanted to make sure it appeared that the Kiwis were going to try to get it started and in their corner so that they could make a tag and get Williams out right away. But that strategy was defeated when Piper pulled his. I remember he submitted due to pain to that left arm. They've only had a few minute rest period here and they're right back to it. That is Martel and Piper working on the left arm. They are defending their tag team championships. Rose circling around the ring. And here comes Miller. Rose got the referee's attention. That was the whole idea. Barr got belted. Or rather, Martel got belted as Barr was looking the other way. And Williams finally out of there. First time there's been a change on the Kiwis in this match. Turnbuckle treatment for Martel. Flying bear for the takedown. Crazy Butch Miller headlock from behind on Martel. Cheerleading by Piper. Martel being worked on. Piper and Martel had it pretty much all their own way. The first fall, finally getting a submission out of Luke Williams, still grasping that left arm. Rick Martel. The tag. Martel gets the tag on Roddy Piper. Sandy Barr did not see it. Now the Kiwis faking a tag. Now, Williams coming over to catch Martel in the corner. They've got him draped across the top ropes in the far neutral corner. Watch out. Bringing him down, running to the elbow of Miller. The Kiwis now getting things going their way. Martel down. Watch the tag out of there. Close, but not quite close enough. A whip. Oh, elbow right to the point of the chin of Martel. Rose over there yelling. Get him. Pin him. Piper in to save it. Well, there was a count of three. He was too late. There was a pin. This match is all even at a ball apiece. The title match, all even. We'll be back. We're going to go back to studio for this timeout. Into the arena, on the arena floor, that he will cause the disqualification of the Kiwis. Barr told him to use the PA mic to do it, saying, I think you caused that ball to go that way, and I don't want you on the floor. You just stay in the dressing room, or the Kiwis will be disqualified. They're going after Miller. Miller and Martel going after each other. Now they've gotten over in the Kiwis corner. We're doing some changing of equipment here. Hope you will excuse me if I seem to get lost in train of thought or lose the action momentarily. We seem to have had one of our microphones go out. We will try to fix that one. Martel is in there against Williams. We will check the other mic now, and it seems to be working. Bobby Larnheit has done it again. Thank you, Abbott Robert. As we get the old broken microphone out of the way, the one that's working, into the game. And right now, Martel would like to make the tag out and get Roddy Piper into the game. Third and deciding fall. Rose accused of some interference in that last fall. Sandy Barr warned him publicly. He was on the floor of the arena. The Kiwis would be disqualified. Miller in. Keeping Martel from getting over to tag the Scotsman. Rick Martel. Back with a drop kick. He hit the four hard, however. Piper trying to get him over for the tag. He is stopped just short. Miller able to get over and tag Williams, Luke Williams in. The Kiwis, the sheep herders from New Zealand. Ready, body slam. And a flying knee, a flying elbow on Martel. Piper in to save at that time. Martel in trouble. Williams working on him. We are in the third fall, a best 2 out of 3 championship match for those tag team titles. Martel caught right on the point of the chin. 1, 2, and... No, the arm on the way down, or was it Williams that picked him up? They might think they have him put away and want to punish him. Get back to that crippling that they brag about. Martel staggers Miller. Miller back at Rick, and again nails Martel. One, two, and Martel able to flail kick. Williams chased back out by referee Sandy Barr. Now, whip and a leapfrog and a double tackle, flying tackle. In effect, that's what it was. In reality, they were both out of position to make the move, any move they wanted to. Martel, I think, went into the ropes awkwardly, twisted, and they are both just barely conscious. Martel kicking Miller off as he tries to get to him. Martel trying to get up for the tag. Miller trying to get to Williams and does so. A dive and the tag is good. Here comes Rowdy Roddy. Kitty by the door. The Kiwis are smashed together. Williams out of the ring. And that was just a roundhouse right. Back in the ring goes Williams with the help of Piper. It's the head crack, a good one. The whip. Williams caught on the shoulder. He went high and came down hard. Roddy Piper working on Williams. Seat drop right to the back of the head. One, two, and Miller pulls him off. I think it'd have been the match. Third fall action. S decides it. Trying for the pin again. One, two, Miller. Saves it.
10 minutes remaining. 10 minutes.
And a little karate thumb thrown in by Piper. Almost a pin, not quite. Williams, flail kicks to save it with the count of about 2 7/10. Suplex drop coming up. Piper trying for it. Gets his man up in the air. Off balance, he is caught. He goes under himself. Williams almost got the pin on it. A tag. Williams over to tag. Miller in. Piper waiting for him. But groggy. They are flailing away. We're going to keep it right here. We're all out of breaks. So we'll keep
nine
it here.
Minutes.
At 9 minutes left in the match. Double knee lift on Miller. Count of two, and the tag saved him. He's able to tag Williams. Roddy is groggy. And they double team. One shot. Piper. Judo chop. Drops him to the mat. Being kicked on. Working on him. Williams kicked him off the floor. Now going out after him. Body slam into the cement floor. Roddy Piper. Martel chasing Miller. Now Williams gets after him. The count going on. Just has 20 seconds in which to return. Pee-wees, would they blow it and interfere? They might. They stop, see if the count starts over. Now he is back in the ring. A kickoff. And Rick was down, had been down on the floor to help. Piper was able to get over there for the tag, but Rick had not returned yet. Right now, Martell and Piper seem to be the team in trouble. The sheep herders seem to be a little better off as far as the shape they're in right now. Piper taking the punishment. One, two, flail kick off. He saved it. Body lock, bear hug, whatever you want to call it, it is painful. Butch Miller in a body lock, or has the body lock on Piper. This is for the title. Martell and Piper defending. Buddy Rhodes been removed from the arena floor. He's in the dressing room.
6 minutes remaining.
Martell in. Gets him loose. A little double teaming by the Kiwis as Martell is chased out. Luke Williams in now working on Martell. Turns him over. Covers with a body press. One, two, and Martell in to save him. Piper has the small of his back rammed into the knee of Miller. As they change now, Williams out, Miller in. And backbreaker, reverse backbreaker, and another. Miller putting it on the leg of Williams. One, two, and Martell in. Playing it away at Miller, now ordered back. The whip, and it's reversed. Piper able to put an E in the solar plexus of Williams. Can he get out of there now? Can he tag? He's looking around, trying to find his corner. Dives. Here comes Whit Martell. Shoe might be on the other foot. Miller belted outside the ring. Now Martell back to work on Williams. Whips. Catches him in a grapevine. The abdominal stretch. And Martell dropped it. Uh-oh! He went after Williams and Sandy Barr completely over the top rope. Sandy Barr flipped out completely over the top rope. Martell and Piper. And it's reversed. Miller got his reverse. One of the ring people. Piper is given a pile driver. Now Martell has Williams covered, but Piper is covered by Miller. Where Sandy gets up, all he sees is Miller. When Sandy got up, oh, confusion. Controversy is going to reign supreme in this one. Sandy Barr went sailing out. Here comes Buddy Rose. They were both pinned. That is to say, Williams was pinned by Martell. Piper was pinned by Miller. Sandy, who had gone flying over that ring, accidentally catching the drop kick from Martell. He went sailing out. He got up. The two men nearest him were Piper and Miller. So he counted. He did not see Martell, who was pinning Williams. Sandy, a little groggy from flying out of the ring, now Well, we'll have to see what happens. Well, let's just hold on here. Sandy Barr doing some discussion. Sandy Barr is saying, wait a minute. I think they're coming up here to TV. If we get the camera back, I think we're going to get an explanation of what's happening up here. With confusion reigning supreme here, we're going to get Sandy up and get a ruling.
Our team won! We want the belt! You did it, Butch Finn Piper!
We won, Sandy! Give us the belt! What's the matter with you? Wait, you count on us three, then!
Wait just a minute. You know, Frank, at first I was counting on just one team.
I was on top of five teams, the
winner. But when I looked up, I was counting on two teams as the winner.
No way!
They both won!
We won the belt, you count on 1, 2, 3!
He might have been on top of me, referee, and maybe I had no business in there, but either did he have no business, and this man, then we should have the damn belt.
I was the legal man, brother, and I had him pinned, so we deserve the belt.
As far as I'm concerned, Frank, both teams won. I can't give the belts to both teams, so I'm going to make them fight it over, and I'm going to hold the belts till we have a winner.
No, they're all belts. You can't do that to them.
They can do it next Saturday, or I'll hold the belts forever.
Come on, go!
Everybody saw it. Butch Miller pinned Roddy Piper.
Right there in the middle.
These are the champions. Now he's holding the belts up and saying next Saturday they're going to put the match back in there.
What more do we have to do to retain our belts again? Every time we win, they rob us of them. We were counted 1, 2, 3, and Piper was counted out right in the middle of the ring, Frank.
You saw it, Frank. Butch Miller power drive the big mouth. They're our belts.
What are they trying to say? That nobody owns the belts now? Rick Martel and Roddy Piper don't have the belts?
One thing,
we don't have
you're forgetting
belt
one
anymore.
Thing. Miller, listen to this, Williams. They're not the champions anymore either. So, that's one step closer. That's what's important. You guys did it. One
you
step
do, of course,
closer.
General. You get them back
all
for
you
us.
Have to do now. It's just 7 days away, and you'll win them back.
But we already had them back, General.
Yes, but that's where Don Owens and Sandy Barr come in. Always taking advantage. They say we take advantage. He beat him. You people saw it. Barr counted the shoulders, and this is what happens.
Well, I'll tell you something, Frank. We'll be here next Saturday night. We'll be here in the same type of match. We'll be here with those belts held up with nobody holding them. But I'll guarantee you one thing. When that bell goes for the final pull, those belts are going to be around the sheepherder's waist again once more.
Well, that's the official decision. The belt held up. Well, I get a little hot at each other. Well, all we can say, it's been ordered over. The titles are held up. The match will be refought next Saturday. A lot of confusion, as we told you. Confusion all over the place. And all I can say is that's liable to happen anytime you go to a wrestling match. So I hope that you take your opportunity to see the next time that there is live wrestling action, because things like this going on, we never know for sure. In fact, I've got about 45 seconds here to talk to you because we are just about out of time, but not quite. So that means Frank Bonema invites you and urges you to get out. And don't forget that big, the Bouncers, Lumberjacks, whatever you will have over at Hudson's Bay High School on Friday night. This is next Friday. I want to thank you very much for tuning in all of these many weeks that you have, especially since we have gone to the 11 o'clock time. You've hung in there with us. Our ratings are just as good as they used to be at 8:30, and that's only because you stay with us. And I can tell you, I personally appreciate that very much. So do all the folks at KPTV Channel 12. Thanks a lot for being with us tonight. Join us again next Saturday. Things ever.